What's good? What's going on, y'all? Listen to me and listen to me very, very well. You never base your value on how someone else treats you. You never do that. This is a trap that we kind of get ourselves in when we get in our feelings because of what somebody did to us. You know, we start to feel less than. We start to feel inferior. You know, we start to feel like we're not good enough because of what somebody else did to us. Understand, people are going to do whatever it is that they're going to do for whatever reason it is that they want to do it. Don't take it so personal as if like it was against you. Now, I get it. They did it to you, but it really was about them. You understand? It really was about them. Now, of course, you'll be like, well, if I was valuable, they wouldn't have done that. No, it's not about your value. It's about your value to them. Just because they don't value you doesn't mean that you're not valuable. And what happens is when someone who we're in love with or emotionally attached to or whatever it is doesn't value us or treats us bad, it makes us feel like we're not worthy. And that's not the case. Never let yourself get in the mindset to where you're less than because of how somebody else treats you. No, people are going to treat you however they are going to treat you. You're putting way too much value on how this particular person treats you than you should. You're putting way too much value on it. Think about this. If somebody you don't know says something to you, you know, or says something about you, 9 times out of 10, if you're emotionally mature, you just brush it off your shoulder. It doesn't hold any weight. It doesn't mean anything. Hey, you don't even know who this person is. It's not even going to affect you. If you're emotionally mature. Now, if you are emotional, then you're going, what? What'd you say about me? Ah, you don't know me and all. You're going to get all like that. But if you're emotionally mature, man, what somebody who does not know you says about you is not going to affect you at all. Period. Okay, but then what happens is when we're emotionally attached to somebody, we care about somebody, we love somebody, and that person says the exact same thing that this person over here, who we have no attachment to, that we really don't care about, we don't even know them, when they say the exact same thing, now we put way too much value on it. Way too much. It's the exact same words, but where it's coming from makes it feel different. It, as they say, it hit different. You understand? You're putting way too much value on what somebody else says or does if you let it affect you to the point where you begin to devalue yourself. Y'all see what I'm saying? Don't let what somebody else does to you or says to you or says about you affect you to the point where you begin to feel this way about yourself. Let me explain something to you. What someone else says or does to you doesn't make you. What you say about you is what determines you. If somebody say, man, you ain't worth nothing, that means absolutely nothing. The only thing that matters is what you feel about you. Now, once you start telling yourself that you're nothing, then the problem comes in. But what happens is we begin to treat ourselves based off of how other people treat us. And this is problematic. It's a trap. Don't do it. Don't fall for it. If somebody doesn't value you, let them go. Let them go. You never determine your value. Let them go. They don't matter. They don't matter. You should not have anybody in your circle that doesn't value you. You should not have anybody in your circle that does not treat you the way that you want to be treated, the way that you need to be treated, the way that you require to be treated. Get them out of your circle. Get them out of your circle fast. As soon as you can, as soon as you see a red flag on their behavior, get them out. Because what happens is when you start to overlook, the red flags and things of that nature, and then you start to get emotionally attached, you start to fall for this person, and you're overlooking those things, they're going to come up later on and it's going to be problematic. It's hard to walk away from somebody that you really care about. So you got to be swift in the beginning. Stop ignoring red flags. But again, you never let somebody else's treatment of you determine your value. Your value to you is internal. The world may have no value for you. That doesn't mean that you're not valuable to yourself, because at the end of the day, all you have is you. So if you don't value yourself, then, I mean, hey, who is going to value you. Let's put it like that. The more you value yourself, the more other people will value you. When you stop valuing yourself is when other people, the door is open now for other people to see that you don't value yourself, and they're going to go ahead and say, well, hey, if you don't value yourself, why should I value you? You understand what I'm saying? You teach people how to treat you. You absolutely 100% teach people how to treat you. That's why you got to nip it in the bud from the gate. When there's undesirable, man, I chopped that up bad. When there's undesirable behavior, you gotta address it ASAP. Like I always said, never accept disrespect. As soon as you accept disrespect, as soon as you allow disrespect to go unchecked, the only thing that follows that is more disrespect. And you have to understand that. Value yourself. This person over here may not need you. It's not a problem. Remove yourself. You can tell how somebody values you based on how they treat you. Remove yourself from the situation. Listen to me. Never let somebody else's treatment of you determine the value that you bestow upon yourself. It does not matter what they think. Stop caring about what they think. What they think doesn't matter. What they feel doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is what you tell yourself about you. If you tell yourself you trash, you're going to be trash. You tell yourself you're valuable, you're going to be valuable. If not to anybody else, you're going to be valuable to yourself. And you are the only one that matters. Pick yourself up after you've been violated, betrayed, cheated on, whatever the violation was. Don't let the fact that that person violated you like that make you devalue yourself. This is what you got to do. Instead of you devaluing yourself, devalue them. The person that violated you no longer has any value to you. And that's what you got to understand. You sitting there trying to give somebody a second chance that don't value you. What about you? What about you? Do you deserve to get what they gave you in the first place? Absolutely not. Let them go. Let them go. Let them go. They don't deserve you anymore. That's it. They have no. When somebody violates you, they have devalued themselves. They have devalued themselves. You got to understand, when they violate you, you had no value to them. So why are you still valuing them? You had absolutely no value to them. Why do they have value to you now? Once somebody shows you who they are, you better believe it. I'm telling you, devalue them. Understand, anybody that treats you bad, anybody that violates you, anybody that betrays you, they have no value. Get them up out of your life. Get yourself up out of their life. However you got to do it, they have no value, period. It's not you. It's not you that lost value. It's them. Everybody that you're going to allow to be in your life, you got to categorize them. You got to have like a value system. They're either here, 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 wherever. If they can start up here. And then, hey, you got to drop them down. You understand what I'm saying? Drop them down. Just drop them. Drop them. Just like a car. When a car gets into an accident now, it loses its value, right? Because it's been in an accident, it's been in a wreck or whatever. Its value goes down. That's just what it is. You got to devalue people based on how they treat you, period. It's not you that loses value. It's them. I'll catch y'all on the next one. Y'all be good.